Oh, boy, I could get spoiled with this. I like to show off the mountains and some of the natural beauty that is all around us here in Yellowstone. Good morning, Sims. Good morning, Chipbot. Good morning, J.C. Olise. But I'll tell you what, it kind of feels nice. It's a rainy day, a rainy morning, drizzly morning, kind of chilly. I'm wearing shorts and a light coat. Good morning, Wild Bill, or Will Bill. And because of the overcast skies and the wetness, I'll show you what it looks like out there. Here's a piano that is beautiful. Music is played at night. This is me looking out of the map room in the Mammoth Springs Hotel. And as a matter of fact, I'm going to show you what the map room is named for. It's a place where I've spent a lot of time. You can see it behind me. It's a really cool map of the United States. And I don't know, it's 100 and some odd years old. And they used all these different types of wood. And again, it's kind of it's a piece of art. They got it protected a little bit. And just a beautiful, beautiful piece of craftsmanship in really a beautiful room. And it's a room I spend a lot of time in. Maybe I'm going to check out this side. If you'll be mad if you don't see the bathroom. Well, that kind of is nice having some space by, or some, I don't know, maybe we'll just try it here. Switch chair, same table, different chair, different angle. But just a really beautiful room where I spend a lot of time that I have winding down and listening to music or doing some people watching or drinking some coffee or what have you. Kind of a home away from home, if you will. And, I like it a lot. Hold on here. Let me see what's happening. View request, go live. I don't even know what that means. But anyway, when do I come back? Hold on. I haven't even got my intro. I barely feel like I've gotten here. But my contract is up in October, so that's the schedule. Good morning, RJ, and good morning, good morning, good morning to you. My name is Ken Tracy, and this is Coffee with Ken. It is Saturday morning. It is June 15th. It is 5:54 a.m. my time. Happy Saturday to you. This is a little show I've been doing for a long, long time, just about 5 years ago to the day. And just about 5 years ago to the day. And it was a time when I was living in a dark apartment and struggling with a lot of things and missing the woman of my dreams and wanted to get stuff off my chest. Well, thank you, Crazy Juliana. And good morning from Waco, Texas. It enabled me to get stuff off my chest. It's almost like a therapy for me because I can talk about life and challenges and relationship issues and financial struggles and kind of just be myself. And that feels pretty good. But for those that have been watching a while, you know, it's not just a show. Notice my hot cocoa packet covering my cup of coffee because I've yet to get my Yeti that I'm very excited to get in the mail. But anyway, for those that have been watching a while, you know, it's not just a show about me talking. It's also a show about me sharing my love of coffee. And with that in mind, I got a nice hot cup of coffee in front of me, and I'm so excited to take my first sip at this early hour on this Saturday morning. My hope is that wherever you are, whatever you're doing, you got a hot cup of coffee in front of you as well. Cheers to us. Feels good. Feels really good. Woke up early this morning, but I went to bed early and I slept a lot yesterday and I think I recovered. I'd like to say I recovered, but I'm still sore and achy and feel groggy. And I think even though I've been up here for, here in Yellowstone for 3 weeks and a day, I think I'm still getting used to the life as a server and the schedule and the hours and the running around and the standing around. And just a bunch of other things. Because yesterday, which was my Friday, it was my first day off after 5 days of work, and that's kind of how they schedule it. I think they regularly give us 2 days off in a row, and I believe mine are going to be Friday, Saturday of every week. So for the other 5 days during the week, they work us, we get paid, so it's all good, but it can be exhausting for this 55-year-old man with creaky knees and creaky bones and what have you. So anyway, I had big plans yesterday. I was going to do a bunch of things. I was going to go down to Gardner, Montana. I was going to visit the rodeo. Rodeos here are at least close to here at a town just 4 or 5 miles over the border into Montana yesterday and today. And I was wanting to go, and I was thinking about going, and planning to go, but I was feeling tired, so I wasn't really feeling it. And I don't have cowboy gear, and but that's not the reason. I was feeling really, 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 really tired, and I was feeling guilty if I didn't go. Maybe I could go tomorrow. But then, as is often happens, God works in mysterious ways and kind of gave me a good excuse. And I don't even need a good excuse. If I'm tired, I don't have to do something. But that's what I'm, good morning from Michigan. But that's kind of what I'm learning. I don't know. I always feel guilty about silly little things. And I feel guilty about not going to the rodeo and staying sleeping. But right before I was supposed to go, big clouds rolled in and we got some thunder. And for those that have been watching, I'm riding a scooter here in Yellowstone. So the last thing I was going to do was hop on a scooter in the beginning of a thunderstorm and ride off to go see a rodeo. So we're going to see how the weather is today. And we're going to see how I feel today and what my body needs and just kind of throw it up in the air and let it unfold and not get too uptight. I'd love to go see it, a rodeo. I think it could be neat, but I'm not going to worry about it too much. And I'm going to try to not worry about a whole heck of a lot today, whether I get to breakfast at 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock or miss breakfast or take a nap or enjoy the scenery or what have you. It's all going to be okay. And I think it's important to remind myself that. Crazily, Juliana asked, what do I do for work? I am working as a waiter in a nice restaurant here in Yellowstone National Park. And that is what I do, at least for the next 5 months. I was living in Chicago, and a couple months back, I had an opportunity and a desperate necessity to, hello from London, to cross the country and go to Yellowstone National Park and work here as a waiter. It's a really neat experience, and they hire people from all over, and they house us and feed us for really cheap, like $500 a month. And it's been cool. It's been cool. There's been periods of, but I mean, no matter where you are, you're gonna have periods of different emotions and sadness and loneliness. And there was a time about, 5 or 6 days ago that I felt like for a day and a half, I felt kind of consumed with loneliness. And because it's a different life living in the national parks. It's a different life living in the national parks. People don't really live here. We have some tour buses and cars coming through and people looking at the beauty and the nature that we have around us. But it's not like a normal city or town or what have you, and your dining options are certainly limited, and your coffee options are certainly limited as well. Will Bill Jill asked, how long have I been out of the real estate business? I left. I did not renew my license for the year of 2022. It had been a long time coming. I was a real estate agent for 17 years. Let me show you where we're at real quickly for anybody new that's hopping on. I'm in the map room at the Mammoth Hot Springs Hotel. And it's just a beautiful room and with nice soft chairs. And there's the map of the named map room, which was built, I don't know, maybe 1900s, that map was put together with pieces of wood from every state in the country, apparently. And it's really cool, and it's kind of a busy tourist attraction, if you will, or something that's famous. I didn't know about it before I got here. But a really pretty room, and at night, a pianist comes and plays music. And I spent my night sitting in that chair over there, listening to the pianist that was playing there, editing some videos and reading a book that I'm working my way through called The Appeal by John Grisham. And Morgan Tracy, hi, Morgie. Did COVID set your mind thinking about quitting the rat race of real estate sales? I'm sure COVID changed me in a lot of ways. Again, I was a realtor for 17 years and did fairly okay at it. I did better than most and was able to work out a living and cover my financial responsibilities. And I never felt that great about it. I never loved it. You know, I thought it was neat because I got in it because I wanted to run my own business. And I think whatever my destiny holds, I think it'd be kind of running my own business. I think I'm a better manager, business owner than I am maybe employee. And because of that, I knew I wanted to run my own business. My first wife and I were considering moving out of state. We put our home up for sale by owner. I loved the experience of that and hosting an open house. And I had brochures and I chased people down the road that were slowly driving by because that was, you know, early 2000s and it was a really hot time for real estate. And people were, you know, cruising the streets looking for for sale signs and you could tell. And I'd be ready, and if I saw some slow driver, I'd run out, offer to show him my house, and give him a brochure. And I don't know, got me into real estate. My very first customer I ever had was a neighbor friend of ours that came through my open house, and the wife said, "You should be a realtor." And I did, and they ended up being my very first customers. Where you are at, Republican or Democratic? Well, I'm at a national park, and I don't think it's super political. I don't think it's super political. The national parks were founded by Teddy Roosevelt, who was a reformer, if you will, and kind of fought for the small man and fought against big monopolies and set aside huge plots of land for national parks. But I think outside of that, it's not a really political area. Wyoming, and this, I mean, Montana, I'm sure, is a red state, a classic red state. But I believe Wyoming's probably what they call a purple state. So probably a little more conservative, but possibly changing politically. And it's kind of neat being here. But it's certainly different than Illinois, where I'm from, which is a bright blue state. And which is okay. And there's some benefits living into a bright blue state. I have a little baby Augie who has Down syndrome. And because of that, there's a lot of money set aside for kids with special needs that might not exist. And they could, but I don't know. A lot of opportunities for kids with special needs that are provided by the state. And although I consider myself slightly right of center politically, I appreciate that Augie's getting the best care possible. How does Yellowstone rank against Yosemite? Totally different for me. It's different when you're living at a place than when you're visiting a place. I went to Yosemite during my first honeymoon back in 2002, I think. And it ranks up as one of the most beautiful places I've ever seen. But now I think I'm probably in some ways taking it for granted a little bit and not as desperately needing to go hit all the hot tourist spots that you could hit. I've been to Old Faithful and I've been to Lake Yellowstone and I've seen some things and done some, been to some beautiful places. But because I'm here for 5 months, you know, I'm not waking up every morning and going, let's go see the canyon or the Grand Canyon of Yellowstone today. There's days I do that, but then there's days where you just need to be a human. You can't be a tourist for 5 straight months because that requires a special energy. And like I was saying at the beginning of my show, I'll tell you what, waiting tables for 12 hours requires a special energy as well. And I'm working the lunch-dinner shift tomorrow. And I'm looking forward to it. If I could create my perfect shift, I'd probably work 3 lunch and dinner shifts a week, which would be 12 hours a day roughly, which would be 36 hours. And then maybe add a breakfast in a couple times a week. And that'd be it. And that'd be 40 to 45 hours. And I'd probably make enough money to accomplish my goals, at least I hope. I haven't gotten paid yet. And take care of my financial responsibilities. Hello from Spain. And probably rest enough to enjoy the park as well. So although it's going to be a long day tomorrow, I'm probably going to make a lot of money. And I don't know. As I was telling a guy in the cafeteria named Brad, money doesn't buy happiness. I do know that, but being broke kind of sucks. Somebody asked me about COVID and leaving real estate. Again, I just wasn't that, I didn't like it. I wanted to form my own business or run my own business. And being a realtor, you know, you don't have to rent a shop or buy inventory or, you know, it's a fairly easy business to enter. And because of that, there's a lot of realtors. But I never really felt, I don't know. I don't like fawning over people's drapes or saying, oh, what a beautiful color drape this is, or what a lovely wood, or, you know, I smile a lot. I'm one of the smiliest guys I know. But you had to be a certain way. You had to always kind of be on, or at least I felt I did. Hello from Poland. I felt I always had to be, wear my salesman hat, because everybody you met as you walked through life lived in a home or needed a home. And whether they were renting or buying or selling, they had their own real estate story to tell. And even if you were feeling grumpy or tired or sick or hungover or up or down or sideways or hungry or at church on a Christmas day, you felt the need to engage in business. And I found that unpleasant and off-putting. I kind of just want to be me. And I don't think me is a realtor. I just don't think me is a realtor. And I like who I am. And I like who I am better without a real estate name badge or what have you. So I was looking to, was thinking about transitioning out. I'm sure COVID kind of expedited the situation. It was so weird. COVID hit, you know, there was talk of it worldwide. But it came into across the country so quickly, and the shutdowns happened so quickly. I remember all of a sudden the Big Ten basketball tournament was shut off, and they canceled the golf tournament midway, and we had an open house scheduled for Sunday, and we usually scheduled them 5 or 6 days in advance, but the restrictions kind of were accelerating during the week. To whereas it became Friday, I go, I don't even know if it's legal to host an open house. And it was just such a weird feeling. And, yeah. Did you find PMI is unnecessary for a mortgage? I think you have to have it, right? If you don't have 20% down. You have to have it. The PMI is not for you. I'm not a mortgage broker, but I, you know a thing or two. If you didn't put 20% down on a, somebody asked if, RJ asked if PMI is unnecessary for a mortgage, but I think PMI stands for private mortgage insurance. And usually you buy insurance to protect yourself, to protect your home, your car, your life, what have you. And but you had to pay PMI or private mortgage insurance to protect the mortgage company against your own default. And I believe if you didn't have 20% down, they would, you know, get an insurance policy to protect them lest you can't pay. And it made your premiums or your mortgage payment higher and made it more likely that you couldn't pay. I don't think it's a great, I'm not a huge fan, I'm betting. I'm not a huge fan. It's an extra cost in a sea of costs that goes onto a mortgage loan that get thrown in, and you're so excited about buying the home and you don't have much options. It was just a standard part of the loan, and you are paying for an insurance policy to protect the guy loaning you money. So is it unnecessary? In my opinion, yes. That's why they're in the business. They should take the risk. You shouldn't guarantee or cover their risk against foreclosure, I don't think. But again, it's people, you know, excited to buy a home and not really having many alternatives. And it just another cost in a sea of costs you have when you're buying a home that I think are ridiculous. So let's drink some more coffee. It's funny, I talk a lot about real estate. And I had a whole mess of real estate followers. Is that Taryn? Hi, Taryn.
Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning.
That's right. Doing my show in the map room. But what was I saying? Oh, I had tons and tons of real estate followers, and my account grew really quickly because I posted some videos that went really viral. And a big chunk of them were realtors because, I don't know, I did some cool posts about real estate. And hello, drinking a mocha pot. I don't know what that is, but I hope your coffee tastes good from it. And I got a huge audience of real estate followers, and I posted a video about what I think in a free market the real estate commission would be and how vastly different it would be. And I think it upset a lot of realtors, and I lost a lot of followers from the group. And that's okay. I'm going to say what I want to say, and people follow me that want to follow me, and I'm going to keep talking and keep saying what I think is true and not really worry about that whole stuff. I do think the real estate industry should be, thank you. I do think the real estate industry should change. I don't think you should pay 6% to sell your home, and I don't think there should be a sea of costs in every mortgage loan, because there are. And people look at mortgage brokers as these generous, friendly guys that give them money, but I tell you what, they're making more than the realtors. And although the real estate industry, here's what I think's wrong. Most realtors are struggling and can't pay their bills. And I still believe most clients are paying too much. And I think the way the industry is set up with the NAR, National Association's realtors being a monopoly, and they control it by running the MLS, which I get, and I'm a free market guy. But if Teddy Roosevelt was still around, he would bust the monopoly and the union that is the NAR. He would. Because it's keeping costs out of whack and charging fees to realtors. And I'm not saying realtors are getting rich, because I know they're not. I was a realtor. I was struggling. I, you know, had really good months and huge paychecks, but I had really lean months because it's so hard to get clients because there's so many realtors. And, you know, I talk about it, and I'm not belittling what realtors do. I'm belittling the cost structure, which makes it most of the realtor's effort is put towards acquisition of new clients. And I had a million people saying, oh, I couldn't afford to market a house at the rates you're suggesting. And that's just not true. It's just not true. when a realtor markets a house, you know, they're doing it because it markets themselves. Notice you've never seen a real estate ad without the realtor's picture on it and the name and the contact info, because, you know, if I get a listing with a beautiful kitchen, I know that kitchen is eye content or eye candy for people. And I'm going to have my face on the corner there with Ken Tracy and my phone number. And you reach out and you use the kitchen, someone's nice kitchen, as bait to attract new customers. You really do. Lisa says she's in her first year and it's a love-hate thing. Good thing I'm not dependent on it. Just something I wanted to try. Thank God my husband's got the bills. Yeah, Lisa. And this is going to sound horrible. I believe most real estate companies encourage, push, say you should be a full-time realtor. I don't think it's a full-time gig. I do not. For some it is, but it's the vast minority. For probably 5% of the population, it could be a, of the realtor population, it could be a full-time gig. But for the other 95%, they're scratching and clawing and fighting for every client they can get. And spending all their money. I know I was spending all my time door knocking or cold calling or putting together mailers or brochures and that you guys get in your mail every day. I just don't think it's an efficient use of time or an efficiently run business at all. She says it's a frustrating gig. I tell you, Lisa, it's especially frustrating if you don't know how your mortgage or your rent or your bills are going to be paid. And my second marriage, my wife and I were both realtors and we were partners in a real estate company. And, yeah, no, it was tough because we didn't have another income to rely on a lean month or a lean 3 months. And we needed a closing or two every month to pay our bills. And most months we were okay. And some months we were really good, but some months was a struggle. And, you know, I just thought it sucked. RJ asked if I ever did commercial real estate. No, I didn't. And I probably would have, should have, could have. But it doesn't do any good in life to would have, should have, could have. I have some friends that are really successful in commercial real estate. And I think in a lot of ways, being in a commercial real estate job would be a lot different than being a realtor. Because again, my biggest issue as a realtor was every human being I met was a potential buyer, seller, renter, what have you. And in the commercial side of the business, you know, not every person you meet has a commercial real estate need, but everybody has a residential real estate need. So I believe as a commercial realtor, you could take your hat on and off a little more. But for some reason, I never got involved. And it might have been a better fit for me, but I think things happen for a reason. And I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be, here in the map room of Mammoth Hot Springs Hotel. And waiting tables and making a pretty good living and being tired and appreciating the sleep and the time off I have today. And the coffee I'm drinking and the gratitude I'm feeling. And I'm telling you, it's a, like all habits, it becomes a natural thing we do. For 9 months, I was working out, you know, probably three times a week before I moved to Yellowstone. And it becomes such a good habit. But gratitude is a habit too. And the more you practice it, the better you get and the more grateful you are for every little thing that comes along your way. This morning I wasn't hopping out of bed. I woke up at 5:12 and I felt like I've been sleeping for the last 30 hours and I wasn't ready to jump out of bed. So I was kind of grumbly, wasn't sure, knew it was kind of rainy, and I was going walking towards the cafeteria, towards my coffee, and I think a drop hit me on the forehead of rain, and it kind of snapped me out of it, and I said, thank you, God, for the rain, the coffee, the huge elk that was standing right over there. I think I forget where I am at sometimes and how common elk are where I am, and I've had some near run-ins. Hopefully they would scurry away. But the last couple of days, I've seen a ton of elk just kind of coming through our little community that is the Hot Springs. And it's a neat part of living here, how nature is so intertwined with humanity, and just opportunities to see and do things that you wouldn't have back home in Illinois. So I kind of like it in the map room. I kind of like it in the map room for coffee. And again, I spent last night here listening to them do pianist play some beautiful music. It was interesting. A gentleman came up and asked the pianist, was talking to the pianist for a moment. And what I learned he was doing was he was asking if his son could play a song or two. And I forget what he played, but it was a famous, I don't know, like Tchaikovsky. It wasn't Tchaikovsky. It was somebody else. It wasn't Beethoven either. Rachmaninoff, maybe. I forget who it was, but it was somebody I'd heard of. He was going to play a song by it, and I was going, eh, it's kind of rude. This pianist is, you know, it's her professional job. She's here to entertain the guests. And the kid walked up, and he might have been 20, maybe, or 18, and he had a little mustache and long hair and looked kind of like a kid. But he sat down at the piano and was incredible, playing some beautiful music and some hitting the keys with extra power and authority. And you could really tell he had a gift for music and a passion for music. And he played two beautiful songs, and he got some applause from the customers that were in here after he left. And I'm sure it was really neat for him to be in this beautiful historic room in this famous park and playing this beautiful music to an audience that was appreciative. And just thought it was kind of neat again. And at first I was thinking, hey, maybe this lady should just play the piano. But I think she got a kick out of it, a fellow musician, a fellow pianist. And probably, I'm sure she recognized that that young man probably had more of a gift for the piano than she did. And, you know, maybe he didn't play everything perfectly, but you could tell by the way he was striking the keys. And, you know, he had the gift, and it was neat. Do I play the piano? No, I do not. I used to know Fur Elise, which is a Beethoven song. Yeah, it was a Beethoven song. I dated a girl in college who was a wonderful pianist and taught me a few basic songs to play. But no, I don't play the piano. I mean, it'd be neat. I've never actually used a foot pedal when I'm playing, typing on the keys. Listen to me, I call it typing. I don't think that's what the great pianists do. Hello, Lisa, how are you? Somebody just said nature can bring us peace, and it's good I'm finding peace. I think, the peace is coming from nature, a quieter life, and a lot of hard work, to be honest with you. A lot of running around, and your body kind of shuts down. I was talking to RJ the other day, maybe it was just yesterday, and I said, oh my God, I can barely move. And he's going, maybe you need to go to the gym. I was like, you go to the gym. I'm tired. I'm in pain. I need more sleep. So I went up and took a nap. Took two long naps again, went to bed yesterday, and I got a good night's sleep last night. And I think my body just needed some recovery from the work week. And maybe that's going to be the norm. Maybe on the sixth day, I'm going to rest. And on the seventh day, I'm going to have a little more energy and go out and see some things and maybe go see the rodeo tonight. Atwood said, it looks like I'm in a fancy place. I am. I'm in the map room here in the Mammoth Hot Springs Hotel. Here early before the coffee shop opens up and before all the customers come in. But they'll probably be coming in 5 minutes. So I'll probably wrap it up here. But it's a really nice place. And there's a chessboard at the table I'm playing. And there's some backgammon boards. And families come in and they'll play some cards. And I don't know, order cocktails or order coffee, depending on the time of the day. It's kind of neat because I know not most of the employees, but probably half the employees by name now. And I don't know how many they hire to work this specific party. But yeah, you get to know people and you see them over and over and you you're kind of a community within the community. And yeah, it's neat. Mary was the bartender from Naperville, Illinois last night. She's from my hometown. And she went to school where my kids will go to school if they stay in the same house for a lot of years. And yeah, it's kind of neat because we all have backstories and what brought us here. Yeah, so a little more coffee. But it is Saturday morning. And I'm excited about my day. I'm feeling a little hungry. I was kind of hungry before I went to bed last night. But the cafeteria was closed and I didn't have any snacks in my room. Thought about stealing a cookie or two from my roommate. My roommate brought in this package of big chocolate chippy looking cookies and they looked really good. But I had two thoughts. We're not on that, you know, we haven't shared food yet. Plus, I knew if I had one, it wouldn't be enough, and I would end up wanting to eat the whole package. And the whole package wasn't mine, so I knew that would be rude. So I let them go. Wonder if she's ever been to El Burrito. I don't know, but that is a really good question, RJ. Next time I see her, I'll have to ask. But I hear the barista grinding up some coffee beans and getting ready for her day. So I'm going to probably wrap it up here. And I just want to say thank you so much for joining. Thank you so much for joining on this Saturday morning, joining me here in the map room. And I don't know what my day holds. I do know the rodeo is from 6 to 8 tonight. And I do know I'm off work. So if I feel up for it, I think it'd be really neat to go down and check it out. And see what happens at a rodeo and watch bulls and horses bucking cowboys and clowns and calf lassoing and whatever else goes on at a rodeo. But I think it could be a neat experience. Lisa says she can't wait to go to Yellowstone. Yeah, you should. It's really cool. I was thinking about it. If you were by yourself, they have these tour buses coming through, and that might be a neat way to go. You're traveling with a busload of people. It may or may not be. You're not working on your own schedule, but they're probably going to take you to the places, the must-see places that everybody talks about and show you some things you might not have seen if you're on your own. But it might be fun just to experience it on your own and take your own time. And if you want to hang out on a day just enjoying the quiet or the music of the map room, you can. And you're not working on anybody else's schedule. So, but you should come out. It is beautiful. You should check out a lot of our national parks. I'd like to see a few more in the next couple of years because I'm really enjoying my stay at Yellowstone. I thought Grand Canyon was beautiful and Yosemite was spectacular as well. But there's Glacier just to the north. And a whole bunch of others not too far away. Yeah. So anyway, again, it's Saturday morning. One more sip of coffee. Want to thank you for joining. I appreciate you for hopping on. I'm going to go get some snacks. I walked through the cafeteria and it was sausage and biscuits and bacon and gravy and hash browns. I am concerned about my diet. Every day I eat, you know, like yesterday I said, I'll take some spinach leaves, some broccoli, some cauliflower, just raw from the salad bar and some peppers and kind of just eat them dry. Because, yeah, every breakfast they serve sausage. I mean, it's delicious, but I don't know. In 5 months, I'd like to see the change in my cholesterol levels from when I started to when I left because probably eating too much sausage and gravy. But anyway, yeah, again, it's Saturday morning. I want to thank you so much for joining. I appreciate you for following along in my journey that is life. Hope you had a wonderful week behind you and you had a great, great night, great sleep last night. And I hope you're feeling good. You're excited about your weekend. You're loving yourself. You're forgiving yourself. And as always, I hope to talk to you soon. Bye-bye.